Hi, today I'm going to show you how to use Wavin reducers and the Wavin validation view. For this demonstration, we're going to use the Wavin AS package. These two features will help you to get your project into an as-built level of detail, which means more accurate space allocation, better clash detection, and overall cost effectiveness in your BIM project. On the right-hand side, you can see how Revit's standard piping system deals with reducers, and as you can see, the reducer is always a single piece. It is very short and it's always centric, which is not the case in real life. On the left-hand side, the Wavin content shows the reducer as a single family, comprising nested components, which by themselves should not be used manually in projects. To draw a reducer, simply use any length of pipe and change the diameter size. A custom fitting is created. Revit software always includes reducers as centric items. In order to solve this problem, here's where Wavin content allows you to apply eccentricity. More about eccentricity will be covered in another dedicated Wavin tutorial. Now I'll show you the Wavin validation view. To open it, find it in the project browser and double-click. The green filter is used to identify non-Wavin sanitary products. The orange filter is used to solve the problem of the unlimited pipe length that Revit allows you to draw in any project. The orange color means that the pipe segment is longer than available in catalog pipe lengths. This can be fixed by using the split element tool in Revit or with its shortcut SL to split pipes into separate elements. As you can see, the orange color is now gone. The red filter is used to label the custom or non-functioning fittings. In this case, you have to apply eccentricity. Wavin validation view is very useful to find leftover custom fittings in a project and fix them. These two features, Bends and Wavin Validation View, help you to arrive at an as-built level of detail. Thank you for watching. Make sure you watch the rest of the Wavin Tips and Tricks tutorials on our dedicated BIM channel.